Prolog finds solutions using top-down search. The cut is one way for the programmer to exert some control. As the name suggests, the cut makes search spaces smaller. It's placed in rules and it always succeeds. It's used for its side effects. First, it prevents the use of further choices for any terms in the rule matched before the cut. Second, it commits the choice of rule for the current goal. Let's look at an example of the first of these side effects. This program has two possible values for I and three possible values for J. Combining these gives six possible ways to succeed. What happens if we add a cut? Put the cut between IX and JY, and the number of ways to succeed is halved. Let's see why by visualizing the search. As usual, we'll add a number to each clause, and the goal to prove is the content of the starting node. The solution process is to use matching, searching the clauses from the top of the program. Clause 1 succeeds, giving us new sub-goals to prove. With more than one goal, Prolog works from the left first, so the next goal is IX. Again, searching from the top, this time we match with clause 2. This gives a variable binding for X. The first of the remaining goals is the cut. The cut is built in and it succeeds, with the side effect of removing potential branches above it in the search space. This leaves the goal JY, and again Prolog searches from the top of the program. If the user refuses the three bindings for Y by typing semicolons, there are no solutions left for the original goal. The cut only succeeds once, and it has removed the backtracking points from the two nodes above it. So this time there are no solutions with X equals 2. The cut has changed the program behavior thanks to its side effects. Here is a second example with three rules. For the query PX, this program offers three solutions. But with a cut in the middle of the second rule, the number of solutions is 1. Let's look at this search space. First, we'll number the clauses. This time, there are 11. The initial goal of PX matches clause 1, giving a new subgoal. That matches clause 4 with one variable binding. If the user asks for more solutions, the place with other possibilities is the root node. Clause 2 is an alternative match that gives 5 subgoals. Working from the left, BX matches clause 5 with one variable binding. And C1 matches clause 6 as it is. Now we've reached the cut, which succeeds and introduces controls on backtracking. This means that when D1 fails, there are no other branches left in the search. We can't try X equals 2 because the cut has fixed the choice of X equals 1. And we can't try the third rule in clause 3 because the cut has also fixed clause 2 as the choice for solving PX.